Hey there, this time around I'd like to show you what kind of features come with the new version of the MozBar extension for Google Chrome. As any other extension, you can just go to Google Web Store and search for MozBar there. Once you've found the extension, you can just click it and install. Okay, so once you have the extension installed, and once you search something in Google, you should see the following options over here. And by the way, you can toggle on and off the extension by clicking this M icon, just like that. Now, once you search for something, for starters, you'll notice this gray bar over here. And by the way, first off, I'm gonna show you what free features this MozBar tool has to offer, and then I also mention the features that are available for paid subscribers only. So first off, the free features. So once you have it installed, you can search for term, and then you have the option to export the SERP analysis in CSV, so you'll be able to export it and then open either in your Microsoft Excel or Google Docs, Google Style Sheets, in order to proceed with analyzing the data. So it's a very neat feature because you'll be able to export it and process further. Other than that, you have this option that is called Search Profiles. And what it allows you to do is select what kind of SERPs you want to see. For example, you can see Google SERPs, Bing SERPs, Yahoo SERPs. And other than that, you can even add your new and custom SERP, custom search profile, which allows you, for example, specify the search engine. Also, you can specify whether you want to see non-personalized or personalized results. If you want to see non-personalized results, you just need to tick this checkbox. Also, you can select the country, region, city, and name your search profile. Then down, you can just click the Create Profile button, and then you'll be able to just select this profile while analyzing SERPs for different clients from appropriate locations. For now, I'll just cancel it. Okay, now what happens if you actually analyze an actual site? This MozBar tool allows you to, first of all, perform a page analysis. So you can just click this option and then you'll see all sorts of on-page elements, such as URL, page title, meta description, meta keywords, H1 headings, H2 headings, and so on. Also, general attributes, such as meta robots, rel canonical, page load time, and so on. By the way, you want to keep it under 3 seconds. In my case, it loads longer, so I got a problem here, which I need to fix. So you see, I just pinpointed a problem right away. Other than that, you have the option to check inbound links and their parameters, such as page authority, domain authority, and stuff like that. Then you can see the markup if the page has it. For example, authorship, schema.org, open graph, and so on, including Twitter cards. And finally, HTTP status, which is 200, which is okay. Now, let's disable this option and go to highlight links. This is a very neat feature because it allows you to actually see different kinds of links. For example, if I want to see followed links highlighted, I just click this option and all the followed links, including on images, are highlighted, and I can see which ones are followed ones. Okay, now let's click on no followed and see which ones are now followed. For example, these icons are now followed. Now let's check external links, and these are external links on images, text link, and these icons. Also, we can see internal links. So the banner is an internal link, has an internal link. These links are internal ones, and so on. Other than that, if you search for a specific term on a page, say web design, you can just click this highlight option, and all the words will be highlighted. For example, in my case, it's over here. If I disable it, see, it's not highlighted now. So that's when it comes to highlight links. Other than that, you can see the most crucial SEO metrics, such as page authority, Moz rank, Moz trust, amount of links, and other than that, root domain SEO metrics such as domain authority, domain rank, domain trust, and other than that, you also can see your social activity stats, for example, Facebook likes, tweets, retweets, and Google Plus likes. That's a very crucial thing nowadays, because it really looks that social media at least correlates with high rankings. So that's what you get when you have the free version of the MozBar tool. Once you are a paid subscriber, you can see some extra data. For example, you can see the amount of links from root domains. So you can actually see the amount of links, both the amount of links and the actual amount of domains they come from. Also, you can see, and these are the links that come to this particular page, the homepage of webvisit.com. Once you are a paid subscriber, you can also see the amount of both links and domains pointing to your site in general. So not just to this particular page, but the site in general. Also, you have the option to see the amount of links to the subdomain. And that's pretty much it when it comes to the SEO metrics that you can see when you check a particular site. And before you go, I'd like to mention the following feature. Thing is, paid subscribers have the option to also assess keyword difficulty. So we can just specify your keyword, click the Get Keyword Difficulty button, and it will show you how hard it will be to rank number one for this particular keyword. So that's pretty much the options that come with the new MozBar that you definitely want to install if you're serious about SEO, or in other words, about marketing, and especially if you do it on a regular basis for multiple customers. Thanks for your time. Hope it helps. Did you happen to make sure that your WordPress site is A-OK in terms of on-page and technical SEO? No? Thing is, if you did not properly take care of your WordPress SEO, your site will not rank as high as it could. Take my SEO crash course for WordPress users, and you'll be able to fix all your on-page and technical WordPress SEO issues, such as installing and configuring SEO plugins, robots.txt, XML sitemaps, using synonyms, and image optimization, video SEO, permalinks, and the list goes on and on. This course allows you to put your WordPress SEO in order quickly and efficiently. Just click the button to learn more.